favor to Mackey Arena. Swanigan and Bryant and the Hoosiers get the first possession of the night. And a change in the starting lineup for Indiana. Freddie McSwain Jr. is in the game in the spot that Deron Davis had the last few games.
I thought Freddie McSwain played great in his 9 minutes. Now, it's hard to say, okay, a guy played great in 9 minutes in the first game. He did. He had 5 rebounds, went to the offensive glass, and guarded Swanigan better than anybody.
Indiana nearly with a turnover, and now they do turn it over. Maybe the biggest problem this team has had all season. Vince Edwards flying to the other end.
You just saw Indiana's season in a nutshell. Unforced turnover, don't get back on defense, give up a bucket.
And a reach-in foul by P.J. Thompson.
They had leads late against Arkansas Little Rock last year, Cincinnati 2 years ago. That's what Boiler fans are dying to see.
Offensive foul, McSwain. Purdue winning the first game in Bloomington on the 9th of February, 69-64. Purdue coming off a loss at Michigan over the weekend. How about the way the Wolverines are playing recently? And Indiana coming off
the game with Northwestern, Dan. Crazy. A 22-0 run to end the half. Then they get down again, go on an 8-0 run to win the game.
Yeah. You mentioned the wins over Kansas and Carolina. Other than that, the non-conference schedule was not very strong. And, of course, they've struggled mightily in Big Ten play, just 6-10.
Yeah, and you can blame it on injury all you want. OG Anunoby's not in. Colin Hartman. But the truth of the matter is, this team, as Tom Crean will tell you, anybody will tell you, is leadership free. There isn't a lot of leadership. There is a distance between the coaching staff and the players, and that's not good.
Swanigan, better than 12 rebounds per game, picks up his first, and Matthias converts to the other end.
And he just went down on the block, posted Robert Johnson, knocked it in. Matthias, I think he's a defensive player of the year in the league, and he's certainly among the most improved.
Tough shot for Thomas Bryant, a loose ball down to Matthias. Here come the Boilermakers again. Swanigan spins to the baseline, left hand, no. Edwards with a putback. What a 2 minutes and change for Vincent Edwards.
I got to tell you, McSwain is doing a nice job on Swanigan. Forced a turnover, then the shot, but no blockout. Dan, in the first game, 7 of the first 17 points scored by Purdue came off unforced Indiana turnovers where, and I'm being literal here, they just gave it to the other team.
Tom Crean pulled both of his bigs out of the game, and he brought in Deron Davis and Juwan Morgan. Turnover Purdue.
For Indiana against Purdue, the key is going to be guard play and handling the basketball.
Indiana still looking to break the ice, 3 minutes in. Davis draws a double team, muscling his way inside, won't go down for him, but an offensive rebound by Morgan.
Well, they feel like Morgan's getting healthy. He had an ankle.
Nice drive by Newkirk.
He's been good. Back to Morgan, he had an ankle. He stepped on the foot of Larry Scarrato, one of the officials, missed two games that they won, and they feel like he is back in business right now, and that's huge because he's a terrific all-around player, Juwan Morgan.
As you said, if Indiana's going to even get into the bubble conversation, as Swanigan with a nice jump hook, you got to figure they need this one. They need to beat Ohio State and Columbus on the weekend. They probably need to win a couple in the Big Ten tournament.
There's no question. But right now, you know, they have two, and this is going to be big, depending on how the committee talks about it. They have two of the biggest wins of the year.
Yeah.
You know, first game of the year, Kansas, and then North Carolina at home.
Shot clock down to 7. Robert Johnson, crossover on Klein, inside, and he somehow finds a way.
They're going to drive Ryan Klein. Robert Johnson came to the top of the key. He immediately went at Klein. Got to tell you, Swanigan did a great job of coming over, but Johnson too good.
Swanigan stepping out. He can knock down the 3. Off to Matthias, who can really knock down the 3, but he left this one short.
That's a bad shot. The ball never left the left side of the court for Purdue and Indiana. You swing the ball, good things happen.
Blackman driving it, and Indiana's guards getting into the paint to bring them back within 2. P.J. Thompson.
Another bad shot. Yeah,
2 quick 3s the last 2 times down.
Just don't need, again, you need to swing the ball a little bit.
Newkirk spinning into the paint. The cutter is Davis. And it's Purdue ball. Thompson forcing on Johnson, draws the foul.
You know, the one thing I get told by NBA people, including our own Jeff Van Gundy, I think it'll be the last. I personally hope it's not. I think he's been great for Purdue, and Purdue's been great for him.
Been an interesting few days for Spike. Of course, Purdue's at Michigan for their senior day, where he spent 4 years, and now the fifth-year senior is here tonight for senior night here in West Lafayette.
Yeah, Zach Novak, former Michigan star, said Spike Albrecht's senior night at Michigan is fourth senior night for the 30-year-old.
That Albrecht's talked to him about Trey Burke and said, hey, yeah, I played with Trey Burke, and he went through this like you will, and he did this like you should. Just a great voice for Edwards to hear. Haas inside, and he's fouled.
Back to Spike. Matthias is one of those kids that takes everything so serious. And Spike is one of those kids that goes out on Friday night. I mean, let's just put it that way. He gets it from his father. But anyway, so he said he's made Dakota Matthias realize, hey, you can have fun doing this. And it's really helped Matthias not worry about his own performance.
Thomas Bryant knocks down the three. He made five all of last year. That's his 22nd this year.
And that's good and bad. It's good for Indiana. Obviously, you get 3 points. You cut into the lead.
First on Josh Newkirk. You mentioned Spike Albrecht's dad. You knew him back when you were a teenager, right?
Spike's dad?
Yeah.
Chuck Albrecht was the greatest bitty basketball player in the history of little kids. Like, everybody in Gary, Indiana knows Chuck Albrecht.
Terrific block by Devontae Green. Newkirk with a reverse at the other end.
I love Indiana's offense, Dan. They're not letting the ball stop. They are throwing it ahead, or they're handing it off on a weave and attacking. That's a 6 point off just straight attack.
Haas calling for it inside. Bryant trying to defend the 7-2 center for the Boilermakers. Matthias off to Swanigan at the elbow. Lost it. Indiana ball. And then a poor decision there by Morgan. Had a safe pass right beside him and tried for a low percentage look ahead to a teammate.
My apologies. That was on Bryant. Yeah. Bryant had moved over onto Haas.
Edwards into Haas. Edwards corner three, weak side rebound, Swanigan. Matthias with a step in jumper, got it.
Hey, it wasn't bad defense. James Blackman got shot fake, stayed down, but Matthias just playing with a ton of confidence, Dave. When he can shot fake and take one step going to his right, he is death, Dakota Matthias.
Blackman trying to get free. Matthias on him. Shot clock a factor again. It'll be Morgan for three.
Half court offense, Indiana struggling. Not a lot of movement, not a lot of ball side to side. Full court offense, transition, great.
Swanigan for three. Too strong, and Morgan rips down a two-handed rebound. In transition, Newkirk from Blackman, and Indiana has tied it up.
Again, Dave. When Indy, Dan.
Hi, Dan Shulman.
Dan Dockus.
Dave will be with you on the weekend.
When Indiana just comes down, throws it ahead, or reverses it and stays with offense, they're really good.
Bryant got a piece of that attempt by Haas.
First time all year I've seen somebody block Haas. First time. Nobody's been able to go up with Haas. Now this will be a tough possession unless they get it reversed.
Wide open Bryant. Not there on the three, and Swanigan, another rebound. Haas again. And a travel is called. They're more concerned right now with you just remembering my name at the moment. Let's start at the bottom of the pyramid and build our way up.
Okay, Ed.
Davis draws the double team.
They're going to dig from the other four spots, meaning the passer's man or the man closest to the top is going to dig in on the post. That time, Davis held on to the ball, so he just doubled, turned it over.
That's five Indiana turnovers in 8.5 minutes. They average about 15 a game. Edwards with a floater in and out.
Well, Edwards just blew past Green. Another unforced turnover by Indiana. You've got to say, we're just not going to play this way because this is killing them.
Edwards, tough shot. Got it off the glass, but it rolled off the rim, and now Indiana looking for the lead.
All right, there's the throw ahead, and Klein did a good job of guarding.
And the three goes down for Devontae Green.
Dan, big life, big stage, Big Ten. You know, that's not a foul. It's Big Ten basketball, Indiana, Purdue. Blow the whistle, have them stand up, run down the court, pat each other, wipe each other off, and let's go.
216th matchup between the Hoosiers and the Boilermakers. There's been no Big Ten matchup that's been played more often than this. Purdue leads 116-89. They really roughed them up back in the early days. Boilermakers really, they really gave it to the Hoosiers back in the early 20th century.
I don't think people nationally understand how good the basketball program at Purdue has been over the years.
Yeah.
As Molly said, the students were out here. Molly and I drove up with my brother, and I mean, it was packed. I've never seen so many students out for a game as I saw before this game.
And the sight of the candy stripe pants when they come out for warm-up, that gets them all fired up here, doesn't it? That'll fire them up too.
I don't know why Newkirk left him. You've got to study this particular game. This game. And in this game, Matthias is on fire.
Tied again, this time at 17. Purdue, an outstanding three-point shooting team. Matthias, the best of the bunch. Davis wants it in the post, doesn't get it. Shot clock at 5. Davis throws it away. Couldn't handle the pass.
And everybody's going to make fun of you right there. Like, what are you jumping at? But you have to see the man and the ball. I'm telling you, this kid's on fire.
Knocks down another one. Double figures already for Dakota Matthias. Running down again. Jones driving. And they turn it over yet again. Matthias kept the dribble alive. Why not? Turn around, knock it down. Timeout, Indiana.
His offense has increased immeasurably.
He's got 8 points in the last minute and a half, 12 points overall. Already over his average, which is 9.7, and the Boilermakers are up by 5.
And Indiana's half-court offense, an absolute train wreck.
And almost everything they've got tonight has been in transition. Bryant pulling his way in, and the follow is there for McSwain.
All right, now, Indiana, they showed that they really couldn't keep Thomas Bryant off of the basket right there. You have to go back to Thomas Bryant and go back to Thomas Bryant and go back to Thomas Bryant until Purdue proves that they can handle him. I'm going to say safely yes. However, Dan, the one thing about it in talking to different people is the bubble's not that strong. Remember, you compare them to others. But I got to believe... because the other teams that they're compared to aren't any stronger. I think they'll be in. I think they are.
The consensus seems to be it's as weak a bubble as there's ever been, although it feels like we say that a lot, but I think this year we might really be onto something.
This year it feels like it because, let's face it, the top of the country isn't, you know, great. A lot of parity.
Newkirk for 3. Great rebound by Bryant. Can't put it back.
See, I don't understand why Thomas Bryant isn't on the block. I don't, you know, make threes. The numbers are great. 5 last year, a million this year. Who cares? For this game, if you're Indiana, he is going to win it or lose it on the block.
Matthias stops on a dime and banks it home.
You know, Robert Johnson has had no impact on Dakota Matthias. Matthias has gone wherever he has wanted and shot it without duress.
Johnson swings it to McSwain. Bryant back to McSwain for the layup. That's about the best half-court set they've had.
It's not that simple. It's not that difficult. Put, in this game, Bryant on the block and play through it. It's as easy as it can possibly be. First game, Bryant had 23. Purdue couldn't handle it. This game, they can't either.
Drive and a finish by Thompson.
I don't like P.J. Thompson. I love P.J. Thompson. There are certain guys in this league that are good enough to get you fired, Dan. meaning the AD goes, hey, how can you win with this guy? Well, P.J. Thompson's good enough to get you a championship just by doing what he does and having no ego.
A junior out of Indianapolis. Step-back jumper Blackman is there for the sixth leading scorer in the Big Ten at almost 17 points per game.
That was a great play by Blackman because Mathias was all over him. He sprinted with him, and Blackman just lifted up, put a little fade, got it over.
Mathias. Again! 17 for Dakota Mathias. Johnson launches a three. Mathias the rebound. Blackman on Mathias on this trip. Edwards with a drive and a layup, and the lead grows to 10. And Tom Crane will use another time.
That play right there. There's no way Indiana's set up to be underneath the shooter when there's only one screen coming and it's a down screen from the middle.
And a foul on Purdue.
And Atlanta just crushed the Celtics. And I mean, like, at home, Isaiah Thomas was like 2 for 13. It was like 52 to 40 on the backboard. I would expect a little better effort by the Celtics.
Celtics right now, what, second in the Eastern Conference, right? Nearly another turnover. Morgan somehow kept the ball and his dribble and flushed it.
Well, that's how you draw it up at the clinic. You give it to the 6'9 guy, drive it, dribble it, kick it, fumble it, get it, dunk it.
8-point game. Mathias, Edwards, and a nice save by Zach McRoberts, the walk-on who's checked in now for the Hoosiers, brother of Josh.
Oh, boy.
Morgan way long on the three, flying out of the scrum.
You got to throw it over here to Mathias. Too late.
Edwards into Haas. Too easy.
Boy, you're not lying there, Dan. It was pick a shot. Which shot do you want? You want to go left? It wasn't there. Fine. You should have thrown it right. You'd have a wide open three. It's not there. Let's just throw it inside for a layup. I like Purdue. Do you like Purdue?
I like Purdue a lot.
Oh, man. Yeah. How much fun is this place?
Mackey Arena, and your buddy Dave Fleming tweeted about it. He said one of the underrated great environments in college basketball just does not get the attention it deserves for a place that absolutely rocks. Might rock right now. And a travel is the call.
Michigan State obviously didn't win the Big Ten. They were a two seed. Here's the thing Bryant could have been complaining about. If you've ever watched Purdue, you know out of timeouts, they always go inside. It's automatic.
So before you said, come on, big game, Big Ten, big atmosphere, let him play, but that's a foul.
You can't hit him in the head when they're shooting. Although
that's where we draw the line.
That was iffy.
Yeah. So a trio of Hoosiers now with two fouls apiece. Bryant still in the game with two. And you mentioned shooting a lot more threes. Tom Crane's good with it, but you'd like to see him on the block.
You know, how about that?
Wow. What a half from Mathias.
I must say this, he played for one of the best point guard I ever coached, a kid named Brandon Pardon. And Brandon was his AAU coach. And I remember when he came to Purdue, he said, I'm telling you, this kid's going to be all Big Ten. And I thought, you're crazy. Look at him. This is all Big Ten tonight.
Lines wide open. He can shoot it a little bit too.
What shot do you want if you're Purdue?
7-0 run.
Jeez.
I know we've said this before, but another Indiana turnover. That's 11 already in the first half.
And that was unforced. All you had to do was make a decent pass. Bryant was posted. Now let's see if they go back to it.
Bryant looking frustrated. Calling for the ball. Didn't get it.
Dan, I don't blame him. I watched him. He knocked the living you-know-what out of Swanigan. Yep. Posted up, and they didn't even look inside at him.
Now the ball screen.
throw it to him.
Instead, it's Newkirk. And Bryant will take care of it himself. The only way he gets the ball.
And that's silly. He's got great hands. And you know what he has more than that? Fantastic want to. Like, he wants. Dave Fleming said it in one of the games. He just wants to be a part of this. Yep. Let him be a part of it.
Purdue a turnover. The tip created by Green. Johnson for three.
If you're going to win, you got to make that one.
Yeah.
You had an advantage. You chose not to sprint to the rim for a layup. You got to make that on the road.
Klein misses a three at the other end. Final minute of the first half. Purdue up by 13.
Got to go in.
Gets a touch. Draws a double team. Kicks it out. Johnson again. Morgan. On the third attempt, gets it to go.
Just by throwing it into the post, and Bryant was able to play out of a double team. You spread Purdue's defense. You got a decent shot. You missed, but the backboard was there.
They're getting second opportunities.
Well, I think Juwan Morgan's played really well in this game. I think he's been active, took a bad shot or two.
You'll be at Harry's Chocolate Shop.
With you.
Mathias, a huge first half. A rare miss. Can Indiana get it into single digits here at the end of the half? They will on a three by Green.
That's their end of the half guy, Dan.
Right.
He's the guy that hit against Northwestern.
Juwan Morgan, who had a great first half off the bench for the Hoosiers, starts the second half in McSwain's place. And Green starts on Mathias. So no Robert Johnson starting in the second half for Indiana either.
Well, Robert Johnson did absolutely nothing against Mathias, and neither did Blackman.
Blackman for three. Got it. And it's a five-point game.
Telling you, when Indiana in half court throw the ball inside, that's second to your full court offense, keeping the ball busting, moving.
They've rebounded very well, gotten on the offensive glass. If they can cut down on the turnovers. There were points in the first half as Mathias looks for the foul call, doesn't get it, but Edwards saves it to Swanigan. Klein is wide open and buries a three.
Man. Loose ball. Bryant gets beat by Swanigan to it. And this is what I like about Swanigan, Dan. Swanigan is a ball player. Like, he has great instincts. He understands where to go. He knows, like, just stuff about basketball. He's just a guy that's played a bunch. And not just worked out a bunch.
Bryant. Offensive foul
right
running
there.
Over Swanigan, number three on Bryant. Mathias turns the corner. 17 in the first half for Mathias, including three threes. Edwards. Blackman can get hot in a hurry. He's knocked down to three here to start the second half.
Yes, Mathias has had the big game, but look who's on Blackman. Mathias. He's asked to do a lot. Right.
Pull up three. Got it.
That's his spot. And Mathias did almost as much as you can do, except that I believe you've just got to run Blackman off that spot and make him a driver and rely on your help.
And it's back to five again. Indiana led by as many as 15, or Purdue rather, led by as many as 15 late in the first half. Swanigan kicks it out. Mathias gives it right back to him. And a foul.
That's so good. Post, guys, the best time to post is after you've gotten the ball, you've kicked it out. What happens is the defender on you relaxes, so you back him down real quick, and Mathias recognized it and got it into Swanigan in great position.
So here is Swanigan, the Big Ten leader in rebounding, better than 12 per game. He's got 23 double-doubles, tied for the lead in the nation. He's had four 20-20 games this year. No other major conference player has had more than one. Shot clock at 10. Blackman, a couple of threes already in the second half. Checks the clock at the far end. He's going to try to do it himself. Now the kick into the corner and a three for Morgan.
Well, they did what I just said. Mathias came out on Blackman, ran him off the three-point line, relied on his help, but the guy who helped got beat by the three from Morgan.
Purdue trying to clinch a share of the Big Ten regular season championship. Indiana.
Then so be it. But you can't lose because the best shooter in the building, or one of the two best shooters in the building, is going to get hot.
That's going to go.
When a guy shoots a fadeaway jump shot against you, walk into him. He's fading. Just walk into him. Don't slap down with a hand.
Purdue knocking down their free throws, and Indiana still hasn't been to the line, right? Hoosiers have not been to the free throw line in this game. Morgan isolated on Edwards and fouled by Edwards.
Indiana may go with Juwan Morgan on Swanigan.
How about Mathias? Man. But then he turned it back over.
Good cut.
And Green is fouled. Indiana not even in the bubble conversation right now. Mentioned a few minutes ago, it's got to start with this opportunity, a road win against a very good team. It's got to continue with a win at Columbus on the weekend. Then they got to do some damage in the Big Ten tournament if they're to have any chance of getting it at large.
There's no question. And this is a real opportunity.
Thompson, you love him.
I love him.
You love him.
I do. I think he is the kind of guy you win championships with when you have other stars. And there are other guys in this league that are good enough to get you fired.
And the noise level rises. It's back to 10. Newkirk fouled on the drive.
He made two fantastic passes for layups.
Bryan off the inbounds, can't finish. And he thought he was fouled.
He always thinks he got fouled.
I'm not sure any player in the country looks upset as often as he does on the floor. And a lot of it is he cares. Like you said, he's got one to.
And that's what he does.
Davis four. And now McSwain at 6'6".
Yeah, and that last time out, Matt Painter was fired up. He was screaming at his players, you got to be tougher than them. You have to be nastier than them. And there was a big emphasis on their toughness on the glass as well.
It's just hard, you know, because Swanigan has such instincts to the ball. So you can be tough, but he has better instincts, and he's used to it more so than anybody out for Indiana.
Shot clock at 5. And Newkirk fouled on the drive.
First time Academy Award for ESPN, right? And they got the name right.
And the winner was actually the winner, is what you said.
Yes.
Yeah. Oops. Here comes Green. Pulls up at the elbow and knocks it down. With this group, you don't expect a lot of inside scoring from poor Indiana. They're going to have to knock down some shots.
And that was a nice move. Green just crossed Edwards over. Man.
Freshman out of North Babylon, New York. Swanigan deep position. And banks it in.
That was so good by Swanigan. Freddie McSwain was on his left shoulder. He had patience, recognized, went to his right shoulder, got an easy bucket.
Wide open three. Morgan not close. Purdue back in transition. Mathias pulls up. And McSwain the rebound.
You know who's going to have to play for Indiana, and he hasn't played very well at all down the stretch, is Robert Johnson. Robert Johnson, to me, is one of those guys that you're surprised when he misses. He's missed far too many. He's got to play both ends here.
Newkirk. Air ball. Johnson open for three. And it belongs to Indiana. Saw your old teammate this week out of Tucson. Big win for UCLA.
You know what? He has done a great job. I think they're guarding a little better, too.
Yep, they are. Defensive numbers much better. First time had a chance to watch Lonzo Ball, TJ Leaf in person. Those two guys are special. Robert Johnson.
You think he's better than Kerr, Steph Kerr, like his dad thinks?
Can we give it a little while? Can we just enjoy now, yes. And see where it goes? Or?
Robert Johnson, he's got to be the guy, Dave.
8-point game. And a foul on the Hoosiers. McSwain.
And then be quick enough to influence the shot from Edwards. You cannot allow one-on-one.
Morgan with some good defense and then brings down the rebound. A little hop in his step as he goes down the court. Can't lay it in. Got knocked down, so it's 5-on-4. Edwards, look at the speed, but a great block by Devontae Green. But we have a foul call against the Hoosiers. So three subs coming in for the Hoosiers. They go smaller, too. Zach McRoberts is in there at the four spot right now as Morgan came out as well. Purdue will rarely play Swanigan and Haas together. They both started at the beginning of the year. Now Haas comes off the bench. They're not in there together all that much. Usually Edwards is in at the four.
And the reason is, it's charge.
And that's it for Davis. 6'9", 225 out of North Richland Hills, Texas, who comes into the game tonight having played a total of 22 minutes on the season. And he just took a shot to the midsection from Haas.
There's one screen.
There's two.
Three.
There's three.
Here comes four.
There's four.
I'm telling you.
Yeah. Newkirk gets it to go.
And Indiana got a layup.
Yeah.
One guy setting five screens, four screens. And now they play zone with him in the game.
His screen efficiency is excellent.
It's unbelievable. Yeah. He's like Brian Sloan. Yeah. Sloan screen 45, Brian Sloan.
Ken Palm has him as number one nationally in screen efficiency. Edwards the kick. Carson Edwards steps in, banks it home, and a foul.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
Like now.
Yeah. Yeah, they moved it up a week. Usually the NCAA selection show comes on after the Big Ten finals.
It'll still be after the Big Ten final. It'll just be a week later. It'll be a week after the Big Ten final.
Oh, I got you. Okay. Yeah.
Big East will be in there after the Big Ten next year.
So. You're not working with Billis. You got to slow things down for me, okay?
I'm just glad you're getting my name right this time.
Okay.
Blackman. And took a bump. Can you just imagine how competitive anything in the Harbaugh-Crean family is from, you know, shooting buckets and playing Scrabble.
I'll say this. Tom is, in my view, by far the best dresser. Like that whole khaki thing. I love Jim Harbaugh. He has taken Michigan by storm. And it's only a matter of time before he's where he needs to be.
Carson Edwards.
He's going man-to-man here out of bounds.
He's got Morgan on Swanigan. Priller is on Edwards. Swanigan calling for it. Carson Edwards inside. No. Swanigan, no. Swanigan again. Another opportunity, except the ball's on the deck, and Morgan wraps it up for the Hoosiers.
I got to tell you, Priller came into that mix and just battled like crazy, knocking the ball around.
Jump hook. Got it. Little turnaround there by Priller. And Indiana in a game in which, to be honest with you, at times it's felt like they were on the verge of getting knocked out of this one. They're back within six.
And everybody's going to the score sheet to see the last time Priller scored. Yeah, it's always fun. Like, there's a kid, Dave Barrett from Purdue, who was a walk-on. He had a big game in the Indiana Purdue game. Chuck Franz, who barely played on a national championship team, had a big game in the Indiana Purdue game. I think those kind of things are fun, the stories like Priller coming in and contributing.
Where do you rank this rivalry nationally?
Me personally, I rank it behind Kentucky and Louisville, which I think is number one. And the game that you have, North Carolina, Duke, I think is number two. For me, this is number three.
Nick Roberts, no. And Swanigan runs it down.
It's hard to run half-court offense with Priller and McRoberts both in the game.
Albrecht thinking about it. Final home game as a collegiate for Spike Albrecht. Fifth-year senior, the former Michigan Wolverine.
Let me go back to why. You just have three guys out there that can score and two guys you can play off of if you're Purdue.
Priller over the back.
Oh, man, that's a great question right there. Probably the best games have always been the games you're doing on Saturday, no?
They're fun.
Yeah,
they're fun.
Game seems like. I just remember, was it Austin Rivers with the big shot?
Yep. Yeah, that was in Chapel Hill, too. That was one of those win the game, run off the court, get back on the bus kind of thing. Thirteen-point lead. Priller scores again.
Well, no respect from Swanigan, and maybe rightfully so. He jumped out and really got after Blackman, and Priller just made himself available. Good for him.
So some screens, couple of buckets. Edwards. So we haven't seen Bryant for a while. He's got four. Davis has already fouled out. Priller's come in, giving him some good minutes, but he's picked up a quick three. And Purdue really good at the line tonight. Nineteen of 20. That'll get it done. Plus 17 at the line over Indiana. Priller is fouled.
It's a living, breathing organism.
He's got 6 points.
How about that?
Yeah. That's a career high. Pat McGrath tells us that's a career high.
Well, we didn't hire Pat McGrath for nothing, did we?
Swanigan at the other end.
So smooth. Felt the defense on one side. Immediately rolled off of Juwan Morgan to the left. Great play. Nice feed. It's not as easy as it looks, Dan. A lot of guys struggle with that. Drop the ball down.
11 and a half, 15 on the night for Swanigan. Blackman the drive and fouled by Mathias.
Iowa's going out and beating people on the Minnesota's great. Illinois just went into Nebraska. I guess I would say Nebraska. Maybe Indiana,
I mean, Indiana's fighting to avoid having to play a first-round game. That 11-14, 12-13 day.
How about Michigan State? I said last week, I think Michigan State is really getting dangerous. I'll tell you why. Because Tom Izzo knows that if they can just get out of their own way. Like.
Ooh. Priller getting his money's worth on his fourth. He's playing hard, but he's picking up fouls in a hurry.
He's got four in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
He's also got 6 points in five minutes.
Yeah, and about 30 screens.
He's telling them to get their hands up, and the weak side's got to come over and help. He's
exactly right. Look, they've had no respect for Priller. And to Molly's point, everybody has stayed wide with their man. And Priller's just gone, unnoticed down the lane. But
Swanigan with a block. Morgan on Swanigan now. Deflection by Blackman, Indiana ball, and a foul on Mathias.
And Priller, there is no distance between the coaching staff and Priller.
One of two for Bryant.
Well, if you're Indiana, you've got to kick up the pressure. Purdue can be pressured. It surprises me that more teams don't pick up Purdue full court. Iowa did it last year, pressed them into oblivion. There's not a ton of quickness from Purdue.
Indiana's starting to get more deflections, too, at the defensive end. Swanigan draws the double, the kick. Back into Edwards. And he turns it over. Three on two. Green. Great rebound by Bryant, but falling out of bounds, he turned it over.
Yeah, you have to run for layups at some point. You know, you can run for that three, and that's fine. I know people practice that. It's the new age of basketball. But at some point, 12 or 13-point game, get a layup, get play defense, kick it up again.
Swanigan. And Bryant fouled out. And McSwain is back into the game.
So you know what he did? He benched him. And he didn't bench him for like 2 minutes. He benched him to the point where now Keelan Martin comes off the bench as a sixth man. You know, Butler's done four in a row, beat Villanova at Villanova.
They're looking at maybe like a three seed or something.
And right? They're playing so well. And it's all because the coach stood up to the players, demanded certain things, and the players handled it great, the player.
McSwain is fouled.
He's just not a big guy playing basketball. He's a big, smart guy with good instincts playing basketball.
That was funny.
Thank you.
13-point lead for Purdue. A win tonight. Let's get back to the headline of the night. A win tonight, and Purdue clinches at least a share with the Big Ten regular season championship. Last time they had that, 2010. They would also clinch the top seed in the Big Ten tournament with a win tonight. Good look for Edwards. Matthias, the assist. Biggest lead of the night for the Boilermakers. Good decision by Thompson.
Good decision by Klein as well. Klein's first instinct is to aim high and let it fly. That just came out of his hand. He was lifting up for a three. It's humid here. Maybe the ball got slick.
Newkirk, nicely done.
Yeah, really done. He just bogarted P.J. Thompson. Again, I think Indiana should be picking up. Klein is not a ball handler. Just make sure you don't foul, and you can get Purdue to speed up a little bit. It's your only chance.
Nearing the final 4 minutes, and it's a 14-point game. Purdue looking to sweep the regular season from Indiana. Ooh. Beat them by five in a Bloomington a couple of weeks ago.
Oh, I thought Klein had just absolutely put... Absolutely put. I think it was Johnson away with a change of direction. They just beat him on the drive. But change in direction is hard to guard. And Purdue, their cutters change direction. Plant their outside foot. Make you think you're going one way, go the other. Huge. He played for it, won it. Coaching, second time for him.
Purdue, like Indiana, has won or shared 22 Big Ten regular season championships. So a win in this game tonight, they break that tie. I don't think that's not a big deal to the folks in this part of the state. Also, they do their senior night festivities after the game. This is senior night here. So they would have senior night festivities and a trophy presentation coming up. It looks like 3.5 minutes from now, unless Indiana can make a huge comeback.
Congratulations, by the way, to Spike Albrecht. Had a chance to talk to his dad. We had a convention here. Dan Plesak from Major League Baseball Network, you, Spike's dad, a couple of my buddies, and Spike's going to have a graduate degree when he gets out of here, so good for Spike taking advantage of college.
Yeah, it's like a reunion of guys from way back, right? You guys were all high school teammates, various sports.
Yeah.
Man, if you're an Indiana big and you don't have four, what have you been doing? A loss for Indiana would drop them to 6-11 in the Big Ten play. They close out the regular season in Columbus against the Buckeyes. Purdue finishes out the regular season at Northwestern on the weekend. What a rejection by Swanigan.
Man.
In a photo finish over Swanigan.
Yeah, it's hard to argue. It's really hard to argue. Frank Mason has been great. Yeah. School somebody could beat, like in a century.
Yeah.
Hey, we tied with them. All right. Yay, Rob.
But you know what? In that league, a tie's a win if you're somebody other than Kansas.
Hang
right?
a banner.
Yeah. Well, the student section is going to get their money's worth now at the expense of the Hoosiers.
Hey, I don't blame him, man. You come to Purdue, you don't like Indiana. You go to Indiana, you don't like Purdue. It's the way it is.
Pass stolen away. And the three ball is good for Green.
See, they didn't handle pressure. I'm telling you, they're Purdue's kryptonite in the tournament, early rounds, could be a team that picks up and pressures.
So you're saying if, say, they're a four and West Virginia's a five, that's not a good matchup?
Could be an issue. Don't we have to say kudos to the paint crew?
Absolutely.
And all the fans
Absolutely.
Here. What a student section. Well, best of the year.
You said you've never seen so many students lined up outside the building before the game.
I've been involved in these games for 20 years. They demand it by having that sign right there. No other school in the country does that. I'll tell you what, if you go to Harry's tonight, you'll see it. They'll play hard in Harry's. The chocolate shop. The Delt House. They'll play hard around here.
2 minutes. He's going to have a pretty nice four-year career in this town.
Yeah, he's not afraid.
Yeah. Freshman with a lot of confidence, Carson Edwards. Morgan misses the slam. McSwain is there.
Well, it doesn't matter the time of the game. When Indiana plays and doesn't have to play in half court, they're pretty good.
A loss for the Hoosiers makes them 16-14. 6-11 in a Big Ten play. Purdue would go to 24-6, 13-4, and would clinch at least a share with a regular season title. In transition again, Green with a reverse.
He ran for a layup.
You can meet him at Harry's.
Now I got to go home. That's just I need to go home.
Grant Gaylon is into the game for Indiana. You're getting some help from our producer.
No. I grew up there. I grew up in Maryville, which is exit 255.
Gotcha.
Crown Point's a home of Danny Pleasing. That's where he went to high school.
He told me he was headed to NC State on a basketball scholarship until he pitched his senior year in high school.
He lied. He was going to Georgia on a basketball scholarship, and then he pitched, and his brother Joe was a great player, second-round pick. Danny was a first-round pick.
Morgan working hard, can't finish. Down with it is Gaylon. And he gets fouled. That's the narrative. Well, maybe a little amped up on the free throw.
They were both coached by a great coach. Clint Swan is his name. And he is an exceptionally good coach.
The reason you hear that roar, that's the 10th rebound for Swanigan and his 24th double-double on the season. Twenty-four double-doubles in 30 games.
Pretty good.
Edwards quietly has had a nice night.
Makes all his own clothes, whiz in the kitchen. All the girls like him.
And maybe the last time he plays on this court.
I got to believe
that
it is.
Decision will be his. Does he come back for another year, or does he head to the NBA? Shot clock turned off.
I would think that they might get Spike out of there.
That's going to do it. The Purdue Boilermakers clinch a share, at least a share, of the Big Ten regular season championship. And now you're right, Albrecht will come out as John McKeeman. The kid who came in number two, he's a senior, redshirt senior, fifth-year senior. He's a walk-on. This is his senior night as well. Nice job by Matt Painter getting him into the game.
Let me tell you something. Carson Edwards did a cool thing right there. He got the ball to McKeeman so he can have the ball as Purdue celebrates a Big Ten title.
Very nice. All the way around. Let the party begin here in West Lafayette.